as you know that we are left with a few sums of elasticity chapter, so I'm going to do the those sums of elasticity chapter. Today basically we are going to do sums of bulk modulus, modulus of rigidity, and your work done, or basically work done or energy in stretching a wire. Okay, so before we do the sums, let's see what are the formulas which we are going to use with this type of sums. Okay, this is in page number 577. So before you look at this video, please open your Newton physics book at page number 577. Okay, sum number 21 to 28. Okay, so let's, before starting the sum, let's see the formula on which we are going to do sum today. So the first is bulk modulus B is P delta PV by delta V, where P is the normal stress or the pressure, and delta V by V is the volume strength. Okay. Y is the Young's modulus, as we have done lot of sums from Young's modulus, which is F into L, force into lateral length by area into delta L, which is change of length. Eta, which is your modulus of rigidity, is nothing but F by A theta, where F is the force, A is the area, okay, and theta is the shearing strength, where theta is nothing but delta X by L. U is the work done or potential energy, which is equal to half into F into delta L, where F is the force and delta L is the change of length. Stress is nothing but force by area, as you all know it. And P, we will require the formula of pressure, which we had done in class 9, pressure in liquid basically, pressure in liquid, which is H rho g, which is height into density into acceleration due to gravity. So let's start with the sum. Sum number 21. Let's see what sum number 21 is telling us. So sum number 21 tells us a brass rod of length 0.2 meters. So length is given as 0.2 meters. And area of cross section, area is given as 2 centimeter cube. Okay. So as I always tell you students that whenever it is given in CJS unit, please convert it into SI unit first. So we will convert centimeter cube into meter cube. You know 1 centimeter is 1 by 100 meter. Okay. So 1 meter cube. So you can, if you want to convert centimeter cube into meter cube, you have to cube the 100. That means it becomes 10 to the power 6. Okay. So basically you can write it as 2 by 10 to the power 6. Or rather 2 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter cube. Okay. Next, what else is given? Is compressed by a force of. Now, force is given as 5 kg watt. Now, here I have to tell you something. Kg watt. Okay. Kg weight. Kg and WT weight is not equivalent to kg. Suppose it's given that a weight of 5 kg. This is not the same thing. Okay. Force F is 5 kg weight. WT and WEIGHT are different things. Okay. 5 kg together is the unit of force, not the SI unit. So obviously we will be converting this into the SI unit of force, which is 1 kg weight is 9.8 newton. So 5 kg weight is 5 into 9.8 newton. So convert it into force, we are getting into force. Now what is asked? What else is given? Determine the increase in the energy. That means you have to find out U. Okay, you are asked to find out U. What else is given? Young's modulus of brass, Y, is given as 1.4 into 10 to the power 11 newton per meter square. Okay, so these are the quantities given to you. Now, what is the formula of U, students? It is half into F into delta L. Okay, so F is already given to us. But delta L is not given to us. We have to find out delta L. So you can obviously use the bulk. You can see that from the Young's modulus formula, you will easily get the value of delta L. How? Y is equal to FL by A into delta L. So what will delta L be equal to? So delta L will be equal to F by L A into Y. Okay? AY. So you know F. Okay? You know L. You know A. You know Y. Put it, solve it, and you'll get the value of delta L. As you get the value of delta L, now our formula is easier. You know F, you are getting from here. Delta L, you are getting from here. Just put the value, solve, and get the answer. Okay? So, you'll get the answer over here. Okay? And remember, the unit of your potential energy, it's joules. Okay? So, this is sum number 21. Let's do the next sum. So basically, you have to use the formula half into F into delta L. Okay, and F is given to you. So first, you have to find out delta L by using the Young's modulus formula. As I told you, students, remember each formula of each chapter, each class are related to each other. Okay, so you have to remember all formulas. Then only you will be able to do the sums. Okay. Next, number 22. Let's see what number 22 is telling us. Sum number 22 tells us a fluid of volume. So volume of a fluid is given as 1.5 into 10 to the power of minus 3 meter cube. Next, when subjected to a pressure change, so P is given as 5 into 10 to the power of 6 newton per meter square. So pressure is already given to you. Has its volume reduced to, that means delta V is given as how much? 3 into 10 to the power of minus 7 meter cube. Okay, so everything is mentioned. Find the coefficient of bulk modulus of the liquid. It's an easy formula. So you have to find out B. Okay, so what is the formula? P, PV by delta V. Okay, so you know the value of P, you know the value of V, you know the value of delta V. Just put it in the sum, solve it and you get the answer. Okay, student. So this was sum number 22. Okay, let's do the next sum. It's a very easy sum, simple type of sum. Let's do sum number 23. 23, it is telling us 1 meter cube of water. What is meter cube? See, many times happens that the quantity name is not given to you, but from the unit, you get the quantity. Okay, so meter cube, you know, it's a unit of volume. Okay, so basically volume is given as 1 meter cube of water is taken from the surface of a lake. Surface of a lake means at the top of a lake, to a depth of 200 meters. So H is given as 200 meters. Okay, depth means when from the surface, suppose this is the surface of water, depth means going down. Okay, so depth is given as 200 meters. We have taken depth as H. Okay, inside the lake, what will be the change in its volume? That means delta V is not known to us. Okay, what will be the change in its volume if the bulk modulus, now bulk modulus is given to you, B is given as how much? 22000, yes, atmospheric pressure, atmospheric, atmosphere, okay, atmosphere it is given. Now, one atmosphere, atmospheric pressure is how much newton? It is equal to 22000 into 10 to the power of 5 newton per meter square. It is, if you want to convert into pascals, atmosphere, if you want to convert into pascals, you have to multiply with 10 to the power 5. Okay, so see, we have bought it in the SI unit, newton per meter square. What else they have asked? What else is given? It's given that rho, density of water, is given as 1 into 10 to the power of 3 kg per meter cube. Okay, so density of water is given. What else is given? Atmospheric pressure, we have already utilized it over here. And G. G is given as 10 meter per second square. Okay. 10 meter per second square. Now, what we have to find out? You have to find out the, you have to find out what is the delta V. Okay. So, obviously, bulk modulus is given means you have to utilize this formula. Okay. So, B is equal to, what is the formula? BV by delta V. Right? So, bulk modulus is given and V is given. P is not given to you. Okay? So, how will you find out P? Pressure. Because since here it is about a liquid, about water. So, obviously, we will find the pressure, pressure exerted by water or liquid, which is H rho G. So, first utilize the formula H rho G. Calculate the pressure. Okay, after calculating the pressure, now you know all the terms. So, delta V will be equal to, it will go up, PV by B. Okay, you know B, B is given to you, V is given to you, and B is already given to you. Okay, and P you are calculating. Okay, so you calculate, put it in the formula, you solve it and you get the answer. Okay, it's a very easy sum. Sum number 23 is exactly same like sum number 24. Sum number, sum number 24 is exactly same like sum number 23. Okay, so I'll not be solving this sum. You solve it as practice. Okay, you'll practice also and see if you have understood this sum. Okay, so please solve it yourself. So let's go to sum number 25. So here you see we are utilizing the formulas which we have learnt in the lower classes also. Okay, 25, sum number 25. It's given a cube is subjected to a pressure of 5 into 10 to the power of 5 newton per meter square. So pressure is given as 5 into 10 to the power of 5 newton per meter square. Okay, this is the pressure given. Each side of the cube is shortened by 1%. Okay, so let A be the side of the cube. Okay, or length, you can take it as L also. Let L be the length of the cube. Okay, length of each side. Now, what is given to you? See, so what will be the volume? It will be L cube, right? Because if L is the length, then volume will be L cube. Okay, L cube, meter cube. Now, it's given that the each side of the cube is shortened by 1%. If it is shortened, if each side is shortened by 1%, okay? Each side is shortened by 1%. What does that mean? So, what will be the new length? Okay? So, the new length will be, suppose L dash. Let me write it as L dash as the new length. It will be L minus, see here we are not calculating the volumes, okay, so please don't get confused. Volume I have only calculated for the original length. Here first I am calculating the length when the original length is shortened by 1%, okay. So that means L dash is equal to L minus 1% means 1 by 100, that is L by 100, okay, which is 99 by 100 L, okay. So this is the new length, okay. So what will be the new volume? Suppose V dash, okay, is the new volume. What will be the new volume? 99 by 100 L whole cube. Okay, so you find out the new volume, you know the original volume. So what will be the change in volume? Delta V? Delta V will be nothing but V dash minus V. Okay, now what you are asked to find out? So you are getting delta V, you will get delta V dash from here. Okay, delta V you are getting from here. Now what they have asked, so here you are getting the delta V. So what is volume strain? Volume strain, as I told you, it is nothing but delta V by V. So volume strain, as the first part is asking, so it is delta V by V. From here you are getting delta V, V you take as L cube, solve and you will get the volume strain. Okay, so you know delta V by V, then they have asked you the modulus, the bulk modulus, the modulus of elasticity. Okay, they have asked the means modulus of elasticity or your bulk modulus. Okay, so bulk modulus, it is nothing but what is the formula of P by V by delta V, right? So P is given to you, V by delta V. So put the value. Okay, so delta V you are getting, delta V also you are getting, V is also given, P is also given. Just put it in the formula, solve, and get the answer. Okay, so this is sum number 25. Next, let us do sum number 26. So, whenever it's getting shortened, means it will be subtracted from the actual length. And if it is increased, it will be added with the actual length. You have to remember that. Now, sum number 26. What is sum number 26 telling us? Let us see. What is sum number 26 telling us? It's given a metal cube of side 10 centimeter. Okay, so suppose L is the cube, it is given as 10 centimeter. So obviously 10 centimeter you have to convert into meter, that means 10 by 100 meter. Okay, so that means 0.1 meter. What else is given? It is subjected to a shearing stress. So shearing stress is given to you. Okay, so shearing stress is given as how much? 10 to the power of 4 newton per meter square. Okay, calculate the modulus of elasticity, that means you have to calculate eta. Okay, eta is the modulus of elasticity. B is the modulus of bulk, it is the bulk modulus. Eta is the modulus of elasticity. Okay, it's given, calculate the modulus of elasticity is the, if the top of the cube it's displaced by 0.05 centimeter, that means delta x is given as 0.05 centimeter. Okay, what else is given with respect to its bottom? Okay, so we come to this formula, eta is equal to, what is the formula? F by A theta, and as I have told you, theta is nothing but delta x by L. Okay, so if we put it over here, so we get F A delta X by L. So if it goes up, it becomes F L by A delta X. Okay, so you know, is the F given to you? Is F given to us? Yes, normal stress is given to you. Normal stress means F by A. This part is the stress part. Okay, F by A is the stress part given to you. And L is given to you. Delta X is given to you. Just put it, solve it and get the answer. Because see, I've already written stress or shearing stress is F by A, force by area. So, force by area is your shearing stress as given beforehand. Length, you know. Delta X, you know. Delta X is given. Put it, solve. Okay, one thing I forgot to tell you. It is given in centimeter. So, please convert into meter. Okay, that means 0.05. by 100 meter. Okay, so please convert into meter, otherwise you'll get your sum wrong. Okay, so just put the values, solve, and you'll get the answer, the modulus of rigidity. Okay, now sum number 27. Okay, so you see the sums are not at all tough if you know the formulas. Okay, the basic things. Now sum number 27 and 28, and we finish up with the elasticity chapter. 27. Let us see what sum number 27 tells us. 27 is telling us that the Young's modulus of brass, that means Y, is given as 10 to the power of 11 Newton per meter square. Okay. Find the increase in energy. That means you have to find out. Cross section area. Area is given as 10 to the power of minus 4 meter square. Very good. All are given in SI unit, so it's more easier. And length, L, is given as 0.1 meter. When it is compressed along the length with a force of 10 kg weight. F is given as 10 kg weight. Obviously, this is not a proper unit. So, let us convert into proper unit. Kg weight. Again, I am telling you, kg WT is not equal to WEIGHT. Okay, these two are two different quantities. So, don't get confused, students. So, 10 into 9.8 Newton. Okay, so just convert into force. Now, what you have to find out? You have to find out the, it's just like the previous type of sum. So, you have to find out U. What is the formula of U? Half into F into delta L. Okay? Half into F into delta L. Now, F is given to you. Delta L you don't know. Okay? So, other quantities are given to you. So, use the Young's modulus formula. Again, Y is nothing but FL by A delta L. So, what will delta L be equal to? FL by A into Y. Okay, see, F is given to you, L is given to you, then A is also given to you, Y is also given to you. All the quantities are given, so you can easily find out delta L. You find out delta L, put it in the energy formula, and you'll get the answer. Okay, so it's also a sum. This is the same type of sum which we have done previously. Okay, so it's also at the beginning, 21, sum number 21, we have done this type of sum. So, it's the same type of sum. Okay. Now, coming to the last sum, 28. Sum number 28. Just students, be very careful with the indices. Okay. The power. 10 to power of whatever is given. Please be careful about this plus and minus over there. Okay. Because that is the point where students make most of the mistakes. Okay. 28. It's given a wire suspended vertically from one end of its end is stretched by attaching a weight of 200 Newton. Very good. F is given as 200 Newton. Okay. To the lower end, the weight attached stretches the wire by 1 millimeter. That means delta L is given as 1 millimeter. Obviously, 1 millimeter means 1 into 10 to the power of minus 3. Meter. You have to remember these conversions. It's very important, student, because if you're not bringing all the units in the proper unit, your sum is bound to get wrong. So please convert all the units in proper units, either in SI, and if you see maximum unit or in CGS, you can convert in CGS, but I would prefer, and I tell you that please convert into standard unit, SI unit. Okay, next let us see what else is given. What is the elastic energy, U? So, it's a most easiest sum, you have to find out, which is half into F into delta L. Okay. So, F is given, delta L is given. Just put the values, solve, and you get the answer. This is the most easiest sum of all the sums. Okay. So, students, with this, we finish off with the elasticity chapter. So, basically, you see in this elasticity chapter, you have to know the formula of shearing stress. shearing stress means stress, which is F by A, Young's modulus, bulk modulus, modulus of rigidity, and energy. Okay, these are the basic type of sums which we have done in most of the elasticity portion. Okay, so you have to remember this formulas. Okay, so whenever you're practicing this elasticity sum. Okay, hope you have understood this sum. This sums total chapter elasticity sum is your first assignment for your final. So you have to complete all these sums and submit me on the stipulated date. Okay, so bye students.